Unfortunately, Falcons, you have to fire Dan Quinn. You have to. He could be the best man in the world. He could be the best coach in the world, but he has this funk attached to him. He's got this funk attached to him, this blowing leads funk. Happened in the Super Bowl. Been happening all this season. Your offense is good. Your defense is obviously not good. But Dan Quinn, you just have to go for the sake of the Falcons to save the Falcons. You've got the funk, and there's obviously no way to clean yourself to rid yourself of that funk. The only way to do that is to kind of start over with a new team, but you have to be fired, unfortunately. I obviously don't want to see anybody get fired, but, I mean, we're 0-3, and you're losing to the Bears, and you're losing to Nick Foles and Mitch Trubisky, and you're blowing big leads in the fourth quarter. We're not talking about, oh, you got a 14-0 in the first quarter. No, we're talking about solid leads, 10-plus points, 16-plus points in the fourth quarter in regular season games and in the Super Bowl. So, Dan Quinn, I'm sorry, but you need to resign. You need to be fired just for the overall advancement of the Falcons organization. I'm sure you're a great guy. You're a decent head coach, but you've got the funk, and now you're losing to the Bears, and now you're 0-3, and your offense is still very good. You didn't even have Julio Jones, and Calvin Ridley still put up 110 yards. So I want to believe in this Falcons, and Todd Gurley rushed for 80 yards. So this offense for the Falcons is still good. They're still good. They just, it's the Dan Quinn funk. It's unfortunate, but he has to go. I'll be surprised if he's still the coach at the end of the season. Falcons, we officially have to get off of them. They're no longer trustworthy. I know, you know, every week, you know, I'm talking like, yes, we still have to believe in the Falcons. Yes, they're blowing leads, and yes, their defense is good, but they're still putting up the points, and we can definitely respect that, you know, when we get them plus four and plus fives and all that. But right now, we have to be off of them big time. They're blowing leads. I believed in them to win the game. But now they're just done. They're over. Dan Quinn has the funk, and the funk is destroying the Atlanta Falcons. It's ruining Julio Jones' career. It's kind of tainting Matt Ryan's career. His career's already not in the best of lights, but Dan Quinn's funk is ruining him. He's got to go. It's unfortunate, but they have to get rid of Dan Quinn. That's the big takeaway from this game. I don't care about Nick Foles coming in. He really didn't even look that great. He's a backup quarterback that's looking for his shot. We saw what he does when he's the starting quarterback. He doesn't look good. We saw what he does when he's not playing in a playoff game. He doesn't look good. So the Bears are just screwed with both their quarterbacks. I don't expect them. I don't know how the hell they're 3-0, honestly, because they're facing trash teams. I have to call Atlanta trash now. You see what you're making me do, Dan Quinn? You're making me call this Atlanta team that's really offensively gifted a garbage team. Look what you've got me doing. Bears win it 30-26. We'll talk about more of this game throughout the week, but Jesus Christ.